Abandon our brother Nnamdi Kanu.
I'm a Biafra by indication.
Biafra, we can never, never deny our ancestral.
This is Baby Aisha and what?
Hello, my esteemed viewers, this is BB Aishan of One. Welcome to yet another episode on Biafra Discourse. I still remain as with Junior Peters. Today on this episode of Biafra Discourse, I got two posts on Facebook that attracted my attention, that, you know, prompted me to make this very episode. You see, the current trend on social media platforms respect to Biafran agitation for self-determination have drawn some sort of argument and debate hovering around whether or not Biafran people should participate in an election or they should boycott the election totally. This ideology is being driven by two separate ideologies of indigenous people of Biafra as administered by the customary government of indigenous people of Biafra and the Radio Biafra IPOB under Nnamdi Kanu. Many of us on social media have come across so many posts with respect to Biafra people agitating for self-determination in their quest for independence should not, for whatsoever reason, participate in an election or in any politics in Nigeria. Whereas some others had the belief that Biafra have the right, the Biafra people in Nigeria have the right to participate actively in an election, especially in Biafran land, to ensure that those who are Biafrans at heart, those who are determined, those hardcore Biafrans, would or should enter government offices and push the agitation for self-determination of Biafran people where it matters most. Now, I'm going to go through this post made by Nedum, one of Biafra agitators. Many of you must have known him, have seen his post, have been following his post. His post is quite very good and precise. Also, the post made by one Sivia Ogudoro, which was also published as on our website of BBI Channel 1. Since the publication of that post, many arguments, many debates have ensued from that very post. So I'm going to take them one after the other, take some few comments, and then draw up my own personal opinion and leave you to make your own opinion with respect to what we are discussing at the moment. The first post which I'm going to be bringing to your notice is the post made by Sivia Ogudoro. She's a German woman married to a Biafran and a die-hard Biafran from the core. She made this post yesterday on her wall, and also the post was published on the website of BBI Channel 1, and it goes with the title, My Advice to Biafran People. She said in that post, the Catalans are Spanish citizens, the Scots are British citizens, the Northern Irish are British citizens also. They all vote in Spanish and British elections despite their wish to become independent. And they are successful in holding referendums for or against each several times, that's for their quest for self-determination. Why? Because they vote politicians who work in their interest and don't follow stupid leaders who shout down, don't vote. In fact, they don't have such stupid leaders. But Biafrans get insistently warned not to register for elections in Nigeria. And she asks, why? Because they have such stupid leaders who shout down from the rooftops, we don't vote because we are Biafrans and not Nigerians. And later, the same people shall lament that nobody is working in their interest and all politicians are their enemies. She concluded by saying, they should give us one good reason, just one, or shut up for good. After this post was made, in fact, it drew up a lot of controversy, a lot of debate, a lot of arguments on both sides, whether or not Biafran should contest in an election. On the other hand, Nedum a Biafran activist on social media, posted on his wall saying, Biafrans, we boycott elections in Biafran land to create constitutional crisis in Nigeria that will usher in Biafra, period. That was the post made by Nedum C. Nedum. Made this post yesterday on his wall. Now, after this post was made, a whole lot of controversy, a whole lot of debate have come up as a result of this very post. Now, let us take some few comments that have, you know, that have come as a result of this post, respectively. Then I will draw my own personal opinion on this. Then finally, you are expected to drop your comments right on this video. Now, the first comment that was dropped was actually made by me, and it reads, listed attentively. That's the comment from me on that very post. Really? That's my comment. That 10% of the people refuse to participate in an election, while 190% turn out for the election, do you think that you will be able to create your assumed constitutional crisis that you think will usher in Biafra? I went further to say, did you go to where the registration process is going on at the local government? Did you see the masses turn out there? Now, how on earth do you think you can create the so-called constitutional crisis when people are already out to participate in the election? How on earth do you think you can stop the election in Biafran land? Do you have the logistics to do so? Do you have the manpower to do so? Do you have enough conviction to tell Biafrans in Biafran land not to participate in an election in Biafran land? Even if you succeed in creating the so-called constitutional crisis, if you succeed in boycotting the election and thwarting the efforts of the government to hold any election in Biafran land, what will happen is that the APC federal government will impose what is called emergency in Biafran land, or in another state precisely, which is the one that is about to unfold. If you succeed in thwarting election in Anambra State this year, what you will cause is anarchy. What you will succeed in getting is a state of emergency that will be declared by the APC-led federal government. And you know what will happen? An outside military administrator will be imposed or appointed to head the government in Anambra State till further notice. Then how would that help in ushering Biafra? My advice as a conclusion in that very comment is that the best thing we got to do as Biafra people is to confront the political manipulators, the agents of rigging in Nigeria. We should confront them in their own game. We should come out in mass, vote and defend our votes, and ensure that our votes counts. Who are going to be used to be rigged to rig that election? The people. The people, who are they? The Biafran people. And what does the Biafran people want? Biafra. And they want to take over their land politically. So if these things are, these variables are in the right for Biafran people, how come do you think, or how then do you think that elections will be rigged in Biafran land? Many political people will be used, yes, definitely, to thwart the process of genuine election. And these few people, they are in the minority. If the mass should come out, if the Biafra people should come out in mass, voting a Biafra, a hardcore Biafra, not just a Biafra by his side, somebody who has shown a courage, an attitude that he is a Biafra, and he has challenged the Nigerian authorities in any way, constitutionally, that he has the right to Biafran ideology. He is a person and has his own right of opinion.
If you consider what our parents went through in Biafra, what confronts us today is nothing but a cakewalk. It just requires courage. And that's why I did not shy away from touching on every subject that is important for our people. We have to be proud of who we are. We are Igbo. We must be proud of our Biafran heritage. No shying away from it. That's who we are. That's our history. But at the same time, we must move very surely, no timidity, to secure our rights in Nigeria. I would argue that marginalization cannot be an excuse for the kind of leadership we have in Igbo land.
Now, let me conclude on this comment by saying this. If you do not participate in the election, you are giving a free word to the anti-Biafra politicians to go back right into power and continue to attend, frustrating and, you know, messing up the Biafra agitation for self-determination. The only way to change that is to ensure that the hardcore Biafra should take over seats of power in Biafran land. What should be our worry is, how are we going to get people of such mind? How are we going to get hardcore Biafrans, Biafrans from the core, who will not budge out, who will not turn their back against the Biafran people and their aspiration when they come to power? That should be our major concern at this moment, on not talking about Biafra, whether or not they should participate in election or they should not participate in an election. Now, let me quickly take some of the reactions that I got there since after I made that comment. Hussein Lakemanuel said, Peter, in what way do you hijack the political process? Hussein Lakemanuel asked me this question. In what way do you think you can hijack the political process? That is a very good and a very intelligent question. That is the kind of question the Biafrans are expected to ask. In what way do you think you can hijack the electoral process or the political process? Now, this is my response to him when he asked this question. Now, that's my next comment to answer his question. I said to him from my comment that, first of all, what you need is to have a political platform. That is what you need to contest an election. And the Biafra people have successfully adopted a political platform that has self-determination as its main manifesto, as its main ideology driving the political party. The party is now noted to be the Biafra National Party. What more do Biafra people want? And that made the alliance between the customary government of indigenous people of Biafra, the Biafra people in general, to fall in line with their ideologies, because there is no other political party in Nigeria that has that same ideology. Now, after that was done, the next thing is producing a candidate. Who is that candidate that will carry the aspiration of the Biafra people to where it matters most? Who will carry the identity of Biafra into the government house? That search is still on. And in due time, the Biafra people shall unveil that very person behind the scene that will champion the political cause in Anambra State for the restoration of Biafra through political process, that will carry Biafra aspiration into the government house. That such person will be unfolded in no distant time. That is how to begin with. And when something emerges from the party, then all the other people are admonished to come out and mass, voting this particular candidate and ensure that your goal comes. And as soon as you do that, we defend our goals. And when we do that, the election will be done in our favor. Do you know why? Because 95% of the electorates in Biafran land wants the freedom of the Biafran people, wants the self-determination of the Biafran people. Because we are not going to continue in this lukewarm or unrealistic lip service or just bad wishful thinking about Biafra restoration. No, we have gone beyond just making noise and creating awareness. We are going into the heart of the game where it matters most. That is the political game. We have indulged in the court process, the legal process, the diplomatic process. We have engaged in so many ways. We have created a lot of awareness. In fact, that they can be a perfect job in arousing the consciousness of our people all over the world. And today, every Biafran all over the world, including those in Biafran land, wants Biafran today and tomorrow. And how can we handle this energy? Is to engage in the political process, take over our political land space, and push for self-determination of Biafran people. These politicians, they have no choice. We are coming and we are taking over the states in Biafran land. And nothing can stop us. Only one way, only but one way can stop the Biafran people. And that is us, ourselves, our perception on whom we are and what we ought to do. And that is why I'm making this video, for proper sensitization and proper information, so that you will understand where we are coming from and where we are going to. Why Biafra political revolution is a must and a task that must be done. Number one, to ensure no anti-Biafra politician wins election in Biafra land. Send all anti-Biafra politicians on exile, self-imposed exile. Hardcore Biafrans must take over political power in Biafra land. And why do we insist on this? Number one, because the so-called evil politicians are disgraced to Biafra. The so-called politicians are students of our oppressors. They have been used to frustrate our collective aspiration for freedom. The watch and support the king of our youths on the street, trying to demonstrate, trying to exercise their rights as a people. How do you intend to make this happen? One, to take over political platform that we have done already. To produce hardcore Biafrans, Biafrans from the core, to contend against anti-Biafran politicians in the election in Biafran land. Come out in mass. Come out in mass. Vote and defend your votes. If we boycott elections, what will happen? Criminals and blood-sucking anti-Biafran politicians will have another free ride into government house, and they will continue in their oppression and frustration of Biafra agitation for self-determination. If we boycott elections, Biafra agitators will continue to be harassed, arrested, and killed in the process. We shall only be left to lament. We shall only be left to cry out. We shall only be left to suck our wounds while we have little or no power to challenge those who oppress us if we fail to take over the political powers in Biafra land. The worst we can do, definitely, is to rain down insult like you are always seeing on the social media. Rain down insult, insult anybody, say all sorts of words, but that will not make any change. What will make change is for you to get out there, get registered, get prepared, come out in mass, call everyone around you, not just you, your entire household, to come out and vote a hardcore Biafran. If truly you want the Biafran self-determination to see the light of success. Well, I'm going to stop on this at the moment and allows you to drop your comments. You can go to Nedum Z Nedum post. You can go to his wall and you will see this comment or this post that I'm talking about. You can get involved there. Nedum Z Nedum is a very good hardcore Biafran. I love him so much and so to other Biafrans out there, even those that insult me, even those that despise me and despise our ideology through the legal and legitimate process for Biafran agitation to serve that. We are all in this together. Our ideology and aspiration might be different. Our approach might be different, but our destination is one, and that is the Biafran freedom as a nation. So, join me on another episode of Biafra Discourse, and also don't forget to follow us on all our social media platforms. Subscribe to our YouTube channel just like you're seeing right there on the screen, so that you'll be getting constant updates on every video update and other posts from our YouTube channel and other social media platforms. You can follow us on Facebook, on Twitter, and also you can visit our website for constant information, updates, news updates, breaking news, documentaries, and the rest of them. You don't have to miss a thing. We are here to inform you better. This is BVI Channel 1, the voice of the people. And I still remain as Mr. Peters, and I love you to the bones. Shalom.